welcome all of you for today's class. Dear students, in the last few classes we are in the discussion of our political science first chapter, second PUC, that is origin and growth of Indian political system. Today in this class we are going to discuss about the first general elections which are held in India during the time of 1951 to 1952. Dear students, in the last few classes we know that how the British administration tries to suppress Indian national movement and how they are implementing lots of legislations and acts in response of Indian National Congress leaders, and how they are bringing major changes in the Indian political system. We discussed these things in the last class. In the last class, we know that how the interim government formed and what are the responsibilities that interim government is going to deliver, and what are the functions that interim government, which is formed in 1946, 2nd September, and the Constituent Assembly is itself called as interim government. We know these things in the earlier our discussion. So today we are going to discuss about the first general elections which are held in 1951 to 1952. Dear students, after the Britishers freed India in August 15, 1947, and India emerges as a sovereign country in 1947, August 15. August 15, 1947 is considered as the Freedom Day of India, because on that particular day, August 15, 1947, we got freedom from Britishers. And why the India is considered as a sovereign nation on that particular day? Because India is no more under the control or clutches of any foreign country. In other words, we have got freedom internally and externally. Internally and externally. In this regard, when we got freedom, when we got sovereign status, that is internal and external freedom, then we are going to consider, or India is going to consider, as a sovereign nation. As a sovereign nation, as an independent country, India adopted its own constitution in January 26, 1947. After independence, the Constituent Assembly took several years, 2 years, 18 months, it took to prepare our Indian Constitution for two sovereign India or independent India. Sorry, 2 years, 11 months, not 18 months. I told you 18 months, no? Sorry. 2 years, 11 months and 18 days, not it is 18 years. 2 years, 11 months and 18 days, the Constituent Assembly took the time to prepare a new constitution for an independent India. And in January 26, 1950, India adopted a new constitution, but the Constituent Assembly approved accept the new constitution in November 26, 1949. The accepted date is November 26, 1949, but the enforcement date, when it comes to the enforcement, in the which year? January 26, 1950. In that particular day which our constitution came into force is considered as that year and that day is considered the India declared as a republic country. That is why every year January 26 we celebrate as a republic day. This is the reason why we are going to celebrate the republic day. Why we are going to celebrate the republic day? Because on 26 January 1950 we adopted a new constitution for independent India, which is drafted by Constituent Assembly and accepted in November 26, 1949. After the enforcement of the new constitution in India, there are major activities taken place in India. One of the major development, which is the first general elections, are going to held in India, because after the independence there is no systematic government, because India is adopted a democratic values, which is the people's participation in the government. In this regard, after the independent India having its own constitution, on the basis of the constitution provisions which is came into force on 26 January 1950, on the basis of the constitution provisions, the first general elections are going to held in India during the period 1951 to 1952. So this general election which are held in India, the first general elections, are considered India as a, one of the largest democracy in the world, because the population in that period and the system of the government we are going to adopt for the largest country, for the largest population. These are all the aspects that considers or declares as India as a one of the largest democratic country in the world. So the first general elections are having some important characters. How many candidates are going to contest? What is the voting age? Universal adult franchise is adopted in this first general election, and India is going to consider one of the largest democracy, and how many votes are going to create for the elections, how many candidates and how many parties are going to contest to this election, and what is the percentage of the voting in the first general election, and how many which party is going to get majority seats, and who are going to form the government after the first general election. These are all the things, and these are all the some important characters we are going to discuss in this concept. Vidyarthigale, Bharata Britisharinda 15 August 1947 ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರಗೊಂಡ ನಂತರ ಭಾರತ ಒಂದು ಸಾರ್ವಭೌಮ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರವಾಗಿ ಹೊರಹೊಮ್ಮಿತು, ಪರಮಾಧಿಕಾರ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರವಾಗಿ ಹೊರಹೊಮ್ಮಿತು. ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ಎಮರ್ಜೆಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಸಾವರಿನ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ನಾವು ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಏನದು ಸಾರ್ವಭೌಮ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ, ಪರಮಾಧಿಕಾರ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ನನಗೆ, ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಓದಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಸಾವರ್ನಿಟಿ. ಆಂತರಿಕ ಮತ್ತು ಬಾಹ್ಯ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯವಾಯಿತು, ಭಾರತ ಆಗಸ್ಟ್ 15 1947 ನಮಗೆ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯ ಬಂದ ದಿನ ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನ ನೀವು ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಬೇಕು ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 1 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಸಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ವೆನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಗಾಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಡಂ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಇಸ್ 15 ಆಗಸ್ಟ್ 1947 ಭಾರತ ಯಾವಾಗ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯವಾಯಿತು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಉತ್ತರ ಆಗಸ್ಟ್ 15 1947 1 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಇದು ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯದ ನಂತರ ಆಗಸ್ಟ್ 15 1947 ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯ ಆದ ನಂತರ ಭಾರತ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಮಾಣಿಕ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರವಾಗಿ ಹೊರಹೊಮ್ಮಿತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆಂತರಿಕವಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತು ಬಾಹ್ಯವಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಏನ್ ಸಿಕ್ತು ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯ ಸಿಕ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ನಾವು ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳತಕ್ಕಂತ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯ ನಮಗೆ ಬಂತು ಆ ಸ್ಥಾನಮಾನ ಸಿಕ್ತು ನಮಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹಾಗೇನೆ 1946 ರಲ್ಲಿ ರಚನೆಯಾದಂತಹ ಸಂವಿಧಾನ ರಚನಾ ಸಮಿತಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಂಟ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ 1949 ನವೆಂಬರ್ 26 1949 ನವೆಂಬರ್ 26ಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಅಪ್ರೂವಲ್ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ ಒಪ್ಪಿಗೆ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ 1946ರಲ್ಲಿ ರಚನೆಯಾದಂತಹ ಸಂವಿಧಾನ ರಚನಾ ಸಮಿತಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂವಿಧಾನವನ್ನು ರಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಪ್ರೂವಲ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು ಒಪ್ಪಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು ಯಾವಾಗ ನವೆಂಬರ್ 26 1949 ಸಂವಿಧಾನ ಜಾರಿಗೆ ಬಂದದ್ದು ಜನವರಿ 26 1950 ಹಾಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಭಾರತ ಸಂವಿಧಾನ ಯಾವಾಗ ಜಾರಿಯಾಯಿತು ಜನವರಿ 26 1950 ಅಪ್ರೂವಲ್ ಡೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನವೆಂಬರ್ 26 1949 ಎನ್ಫೋರ್ಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಡೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಜನವರಿ 26 1950 ಹೀಗೆ ಅಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ಹಲವಾರು ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆಗಳು ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗಳು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭವಾಗುತ್ತವೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಮುಖವಾದಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೊದಲ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ವರ್ಷ ನಡೆಯಿತು 1951 ಈ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ 1951 ನಡೆಯಿತು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಲಕ್ಷಣಗಳಿದೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅವಾಗ ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಬರೀಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಏನಿದಾಗುತ್ತೆ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸೀ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ವಿಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 1951-1952 ಪ್ರಥಮ ಮಹಾ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ಪ್ರಥಮ ಲೋಕಸಭೆ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಲೋಕಸಭೆಗೆ 1951-1952 ನಡೆದವು ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಹೆಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 1951-1952 ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ಪ್ರಥಮ ಲೋಕಸಭೆಗೆ 1951-1952 ನಡೆದವು ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾವಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್ ಅಡಲ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಂಚೈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾವಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ India. And another point is that the total number of seats, for the first Lok Sabha is 489. The total number of seats for first Lok Sabha is 489. Number of candidates contested 1800. Number of candidates contested 1800. Ottu 1800 abhyarthigalu. 1800 abhyarthigalu spardhisidaru. The another point, sixth point is that number of polling booths, are 224,000. The number of polling booths are 224,000. Ottu matagattegalu, 224,000. And another point, number of political parties, number of 70. ಒಟ್ಟು ರಾಜಕೀಯ ಪಕ್ಷಗಳು, 70. ಅನದರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ಸ್ ವೋಟೆಡ್, 105.5 million. 105.5 million. ಮತದಾನ ಮಾಡಿದ ಒಟ್ಟು ಜನಸಂಖ್ಯೆ, ಜನಸಂಖ್ಯೆ 105.5 million. 105.5 million. ಅಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಗಾಟ್ 74.5% ಸೀಟ್ಸ್. ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಗಾಟ್ 75% 74.5% ಸೀಟ್ಸ್. Next point, voting percentage. What is the voting percentage? Voting percentage is 45%. So, dear students, these are the some important characters which are the first general elections having. Let's see the first point. The first point is that the first general elections for first Lok Sabha is held in 1951 to 1952. Here, the first, after the enforcement of the constitution in India, January 26, 1950, on the basis of the provisions of the new constitution, the first general elections are taken place during the year 1951 to 1952 on the basis of democratic values. Illi Prathama Maha Sarvatrika Chunavanegalu, ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾವ ಆಧಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ನಮಗೆ ಸಂವಿಧಾನ ಜಾರಿಗೆ ಬಂದ 26 ಜನವರಿ 1950 ಏನು ಸಂವಿಧಾನ ಜಾರಿಗೆ ಬಂತಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಸಂವಿಧಾನದ ಪ್ರಾವಿಷನ್ಸ್, ಅದರ ಒಂದು ಆಧಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ, ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ಜರುಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಆ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ಯಾವುದರ ಆಧಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ, ಅದರದ್ದು ಲಕ್ಷಣ ಏನು, ಯಾಕಾಗಿ ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ರಾಜಪ್ರಭುತ್ವವನ್ನು ಅಥವಾ ನಿರಂಕುಶ ಪ್ರಭುತ್ವವನ್ನು, ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ವೆದರ್ ಬೈ ದ ಲೀಡರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ, ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಥಿಂಕ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಡಿಕ್ಟೇಟರ್ಶಿಪ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಚೂಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಡೆಮೋಕ್ರೆಟಿಕ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್, ದ ಡೆಮೋಕ್ರೆಟಿಕ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಟು ಡೆವಲಪ್. emerged as a one of the strongest country in the world. See, when India got independence, India is in a drastic situation. We are having a lots of problems. There is a illiteracy, there is a poverty, there is lack of harmony between Hindu and Muslims. There is a violent activity taking place immediate after the partition of India. When India got independence, some part of India there is a celebration, but other part of India there is a violence, there is a clashes, there is a fight between one religion and another religions. The two religions peoples are quarreling with each other and kill themselves. There is a lot of bloodshed is taking place. This is one of the tragic moment and one of the dream which are seen by our national leaders during the time of independence that may come true after independence August 15, 1947. But in the other side, there is a lot of violence, there is a lot of deaths taking place. Lots of people are going to die because of communal violence. So, and along with that, there is a poverty, there is a hunger, there is no development in the country. So, India and illiteracy, unemployment, no scientific growth. So, India is in the such a kind of situation that it is facing and suffers a lot of problems, lot of issues within. In that kind of particular situation, we are going to conduct and face the first general elections for first Lok Sabha. Because we adopt a democratic political system. One of the major character of the democratic system is that the government in the democracy is elected by its peoples. That is why it is called as a democracy. The people's participation is there. The people are going to elect their own government. That is one of the beauty of the democracy. So the general election, the first general election for the first Lok Sabha is going to on the basis of democratic principle, which is people's participation. The democracy is that the people's participation is there. The government in the democracy, which is elected by the people. So in this regard, the first general elections are going to head for the first Lok Sabha during the time of 1951 to 1952. We have again two houses for the central for our parliament, which is a central legislature. One is Lok Sabha, which is considered as lower house. Rajya Sabha, which is considered as or called as upper house. The Lok Sabha, which is lower house, is elected by the candidates of the Lok Sabha, representative of the Lok Sabha, or elected directly by the people. So the first general elections are going to head for the first Lok Sabha, which is 1951 to 1952. Yes, the provision of universal adult franchises. See the word universal. The voting right is given to everyone without any discrimination on the basis of caste, race, gender, religion, and place of birth. That is called universal adult franchise. Universal adult franchise is that the voting right is given to everyone in the country without any discrimination on the basis of caste, race, gender, religion, place of birth and color. Those who are completed under period 21 years. Those who are completed 21 years. When the first general elections are going to be held in India, the voting age is 21. The voting age is 21 in 1951-1952. Here is the emerges as world's largest democracy. See, franchise their vote in the first general elections are 17 crore 32 lakhs. 17 crore 32 lakhs people are going to franchise their vote in the first general elections. Because of this reason, none of the country in the world having this much of voters, 17 crore 32 lakhs voters are going to franchise, are going to participate in the election system and elect their own government. India is the one of the only the country in the world or this much of large number of people are going to participate in the election system or participate in the electing the government for the first Lok Sabha. ಹಾಗೆ ಇದು ಭಾರತ ಈ ಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ಭಾರತ ವಿಶ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪ್ರಜಾಪ್ರಭುತ್ವ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರವಾಗಿ ಹೊರಹೊಮ್ಮಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಲ್ಲ ನಾವು. ಯಾಕಾಗಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಚುನಾವಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಜನರು ಮತದಾನ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲಿಜಿಬಲ್ ಆದರು, ಅರ್ಹತೆಯನ್ನು ಪಡೆದುಕೊಂಡ್ರು ಅಂದರೆ 17 crore 32 lakh ಜನ. ನಾವು ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿರೋದು 51-52 ವರ್ಷದ 17 crore 32 lakh ಜನ ಮತದಾನ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅರ್ಹತೆಯನ್ನು ಪಡೆದುಕೊಂಡ್ರು. ಇದು ಈ ಪ್ರಮಾಣದ ಮತದಾರರು ವಿಶ್ವದ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಮಾಣದ ಜನರು ಚುನಾವಣೆ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿದಂತ ಉದಾಹರಣೆಗಳೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲೇ ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲು ಇಷ್ಟು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಯ ಮತದಾರರು ಜನರು ಚುನಾವಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿದ್ರು. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾ ಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ಯಾವಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಆಯಿತು, ಆಗ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಆದ ನಂತರ ಭಾರತ ಒಂದು ಅತಿ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪ್ರಜಾಪ್ರಭುತ್ವ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ ಆಯಿತು ವಿಶ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ಅಂತಿದೆಯಾ ನೋಡಿ. So many problems, poverty, hunger, diseases, and literacy rate is very low. As a for kind information, what is the literacy rate so during the period of the first general elections in 1951 to 1952? The literacy rate is 12.30%. 12.30% literacy rate during the time of 1951. 1952 ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾ ಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ನಡೀತಾ ಇದ್ದಾವೆ. ಆ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ದು ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಲಿಟರಸಿ ರೇಟ್, ಸಾಕ್ಷರತೆ ಪ್ರಮಾಣ ಎಷ್ಟಿತ್ತು? 12.30% ಇದೆ. ಏನು ಲಿಟರಸಿ ರೇಟ್, ಸಾಕ್ಷರತೆ ಪ್ರಮಾಣ? ನಮ್ಮ ಸಾಕ್ಷರ ಎಷ್ಟಿದ್ರಪ್ಪ ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ? ಆಗಿದೆ 12.30% ಇದೆ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಲಿಟರಸಿ ರೇಟ್ in India? 74.04%. What is the literacy rate of literacy rate today? Literacy rate in India 74.04%. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಲಿಟರಸಿ ರೇಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ಸಾಕ್ಷರತೆ ಪ್ರಮಾಣ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ 74.04% ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಲಿಟರಸಿ ರೇಟ್ ಅಂತ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ. ಸೊ ಈ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾ ಚುನಾವಣೆಗಳು ನಡೆದ ಕಾರಣದಿಂದಾಗಿ ಭಾರತ ವಿಶ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಅತಿ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪ್ರಜಾಪ್ರಭುತ್ವ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರವಾಗಿ ಹೊರಹೊಮ್ಮುತ್ತದೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೀಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ 489 ನಂಬರ್ಸ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾ ಚುನಾವಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಸ್ಥಾನಗಳು ಎಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಥಾನಗಳಿಗೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ನಡೆಯಿತು? ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇವನ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಸೀಟ್ಸ್? 489 ಸೀಟ್ಸ್. 489 ಸೀಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾ ಚುನಾವಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಲೋಕಸಭೆಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಥಾನಗಳಿಗೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ನಡೀತು, ಚುನಾವಣೆ ನಡೀತು ಅಂದರೆ 489 ಸ್ಥಾನಗಳಿಗೆ. for voting 2,24,000. How many polling booths are going to create? 2,24,000 polling booths are created for the voting. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮತದಾನಕ್ಕಾಗಿ 224,000 ಮತಗಟ್ಟೆಗಳನ್ನು ಸ್ಥಾಪಿಸಲಾಗುತ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಕಂಟೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೇಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ 70 ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೇಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಜಕೀಯ ಪಕ್ಷಗಳು ಎಷ್ಟು ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ 70 ರಾಜಕೀಯ ಪಕ್ಷಗಳು ಈ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಸಾರ್ವತ್ರಿಕ ಮಹಾಚುನಾವಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸುತ್ತವೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ವೋಟ್ ಇನ್ 105.5 million. The out of 17.32 crore people, 105.5 million people are going to vote. Only 105.5 million. 105.5 million. Then vote for that. So dear students, this is the table which is going to explain us that which are the political parties are secured, how many seats. So here the fundamental elections, as I already told you that for the fundamental elections 489 seats are going to 489 seats are for which is elected by directly by the peoples. How many people, how many seats are going to elected directly by the from the peoples? 489 seats. Out of 489 seats, Indian National Congress (INC) alone secured 364 seats and emerges as one of the largest political party and majority party in the first general election. And the Indian National Congress is going to form the government in the first general elections and in the Lok Sabha, because the majority party in the first general elections is Indian National Congress, and Indian National Congress by securing 364 seats, it is going to form the government in Lok Sabha. And the Communist Party of India is able to secure 16 seats, Bharatiya Janasangh is 3 seats, Akhila Bharatiya Hindu Mahasabha is able to secure 4 seats, Scheduled Caste Federation 2 seats, Independents having secured 37 seats, and Kisan Mazdoor Praja Party is able to secure 9 seats. So this is the table you need to put in the annual examination while you are going to attend the question with the explain first general elections. If the question asked in your online examination, explain about the first general election, you need to mention this table also along with the 10 points which I already explained. The first Lok Sabha is worked from 1952 to 1957 in its full term, because the elections are going to conduct every 5 years. In this regard, the first Lok Sabha completed its full term 1952 to 1957, and the total number of Lok Sabha seats are 491. But the elections are going to, direct elections are going to conduct only for 489 seats. Remaining 2 seats are going to nominated by the two Anglo-Indians. The two Anglo-Indians are going to dominate it, because the Anglo-Indians population is less. In this regard, to give a representation for the less populated community also, in this regard, the two Anglo-Indian peoples are going to nominate for the first Lok Sabha. Now, the nomination process, the nomination facility for the two Anglo-Indian peoples are going to abolish. Now, from our Constitution Amendment 104 is abolished the appointment of nomination of Anglo-Indians. The first general elections, the first Lok Sabha, total number of seats are 491. The elections are held for 89 seats. The two Anglo-Indians are going to dominate it, and the first Lok Sabha is having a first speaker called Jimmy Wanmaker. Who is the question is also asked in this regard in your annual examination. Who is the first Lok Sabha speaker? Who is the first Lok Sabha speaker in India? The first Lok Sabha speaker is Jimmy Wanmaker. The first Lok Sabha speaker was Jimmy Wanmaker, and the term, the full term, the first Lok Sabha is completed its term 1952 to 1957. So, dear students, this is about the first general elections which is held 1951 to 1952. In your annual examination, this question is asked. If the question is asked, you need flag with 10 points and this along with this table. Okay, in the next class we are going to discuss the remaining things, remaining concept of the first chapter. Thank you very much.